Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we built the ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired wireless, Active Directory and much more. We are now at the point that we can do a .1x authentication on the wired as well as on the wireless. But as mentioned in the previous video, it can be that there are devices on the wired network that don't do 802.1x authentication. And in that case, we can fall back to MAC authentication. But before we implement MAC authentication, it would be good to have profiling working. And profiling will allow us to create workflows like if there is a VoIP phone on the network, it will automatically be placed in the voice VLAN. And besides that, it's always useful to see what devices are on the network. And that's also what profiling will play a role in. What plays a central role in the profiling is the endpoint database, and let me get you to the endpoint database. In the endpoint database, you can see all the devices that ClearPass has seen. So you can see the two ClearPass appliances, and of course for these appliances, ClearPass knows these are the ClearPass servers, but you can see for the other four MAC addresses that are once authenticated, you can see there is no profiling information, so it doesn't know anything about those devices. And one of the easiest ways to get insights into the clients that are on your network is to use DHCP profiling. So typically you will do your DHCP relays on the core switch and you just add per VLAN an IP helper to your ClearPass appliance and it will get a copy of the DHCP. It will never respond to it, but it will get the copy and based on that it can do profiling of the devices that are on your network. For the purpose of the demo, I will show you both for the 6300F, so AOS-CX, how you can do an IP helper, but I can just do that on the management VLAN, and I will configure for the other VLANs the Aruba OS switch with the IP helper. So this is my 6300 Aruba OS-CX. As you can see, I have just one VLAN with an IP address, and that's VLAN number 10. And what we can do is we can add an IP helper to that interface. And for AOS-CX, the commands are to go into the VLAN interface and then you do an IP helper address. And there you put the IP address of your ClearPass. And I will take the virtual IP of the ClearPass that will bring some additional redundancy in there. And as well, you need to select a VRF on the AOS-CX switches because it has multiple virtual routers. And that can be the management VRF typically, or I don't have any out-of-band management at the moment, so I have the default VRF. So let's add the configuration there and do a write memo. And this is basically it. This will allow any DHCP request that is broadcasted in VLAN 10, it will be forwarded to the ClearPass server. So let's now show me the AOS switch, which is the core switch for my network. And here you can see for the VLAN 11, I already have two IP helpers. These are my actual DHCP servers. And I can just add one for the ClearPass server. So then three systems, so the ClearPass and the actual DHCP servers will get the DHCP request. One of the DHCP server will answer. The ClearPass will just consume the DHCP packet. In practice, you will also do VLAN 10 on your core switch because it doesn't make sense to do that on the access switch. Have everything centralized on where layer 3 boundary is. So now we have configured that, we can trigger a new DHCP. And the easiest way to do that is to go into our access tracker and we can do a change of authorization. We can do a port bounce on our authenticated client. Let's do that. And now we need to wait till the port is up again. Let's check again our access tracker. Yep. There we can see we have a new authentication. And if we now go back to our endpoint database and do a refresh, you can see that on line number 4, we have a profiled device. So we can see the host name, which is taken from the DHCP. And we can also see that it's a Windows computer that has been profiled. And that's actually the device. If we go in, we can even see that it's a Windows 10 device. And under the device fingerprints, we can see the received DHCP fingerprints as well. So based on this information, there's a built-in database in ClearPass, which can be automatically updated as well for new devices, which will map these DHCP fingerprints into the actual device, so a Windows 10 computer. So there's another attribute here, and that's the status known, unknown, or disabled client. This status is purely cosmetic at this point. So you can do something with it or just leave it at unknown. So it's not needed. It doesn't really do anything. But at some point, it's an additional label. So you can use that for additional information about your clients. So now we have the Windows 10 profiled. There's another device on the network, which is my Instant AP. And let me get into my Instant AP. And from the web UI, I can do a reboot of my Instant AP. And that will trigger a DHCP from that device as well. So let me see. I will speed up the video, otherwise it will take too long. It's almost rebooted, so it should have done a DHCP. Let's check in the endpoint database. And yeah, what we can see is that we do have our AP now profiled as well. Again, we can see the host name and we can see the device category. Also here under the device fingerprints, you can see based on what information this decision has been made. So good to see is that this Instant AP, it's not doing any authentication. So by just putting an IP helper on your layer 3 boundary, on your core, on your gateways, on your local routers, just put an IP helper in any VLAN pointing to the ClearPass server, that will get a nice overview of all the devices that are on the network and are doing DHCP. And it will also help you for the implementation of ClearPass, because if you know the devices that are on your network, it's much easier to create policies based on that. So creating policies, that will be for the next video. There we will create a policy MAC authentication based on the profiling information that we have here in our database. And then we can authenticate clients that will not do any .1x authentication or are very hard to configure with .1x authentication. Hope this was useful. If so, please like the video, put your comments below the video, and also subscribe to the channel to get notified for new videos on this channel. Thanks a lot for watching.